Welcome to another program of Talk of Times Past, and our guest this evening is a man, I suppose, who've been associated with the GAA for over a number of years. First of all, of course, as a player, and later years as an official of the local club here. And our guest this evening, of course, is that well-known hurler, as I say, Jim Morrissey. We'll start, Jim, and we'll ask you, of course, as I said there in the start, your hurling career spanned over 20, 25 years, and of course you were an administrator at the club for a number of years. But when did you start hurling, Jim?
It's a very hard question to answer, ma'am, you know. For, I loved hurling. I'd say since my very youthful days, the hurling, I adored the hurling. But then a league started, it must be around 1937 or sometime around there anyway. It was always the controversial league, Castletown, Ballyagran and Capenahan. We were Capenahan, of course. And I was Capenahan. I was very young, about 12 or 13 at the time. And of course, every age was brought into to try and make up 15 at the time, 15 or 16. Yeah. So I was in goals. I think that was the start of my career anyway. But it was only a Paris job, Paris league. But I was in goals at that time, around 12 or 13, as it was. That league, that's talked of course, yet.
And a few players on that Capenahan side, Jim, I suppose. Well, it's worth to mention, of course, Jim was one of three brothers who played on the successful three in a row. As they were the backbone of the team. Who else?
There were Joe Corcoran, of course. Joe Corcoran, the three of us. And we had Frank Milan. He was near us, that him lived over near us. I could keep going. Yes. I was so young that time, I nearly forget. Yes. You know, that
I was 13 or 14.
Yeah, 12 or 13, I'd say. No.
And I think your training was done over there, Jim, at the back of where I live, at Tom Martin.
It was hard to get a field, any type of a field for training that time, you know. But Tom Martin gave this field over. It was handy, very smart little field. But God, I often think of that since the fellas that played there after. It was all the real training ground there. It was a little bit away from us, but we were cycled there. There was no such thing as car. We cycled up there. But that field now, in later years, they was coming there from three parishes, from Rockhill, Grana, and Castletown. We were Castletown. You had the Chalks of Grana and Mixex and the Milans from Rory and ourselves. God, we was often said that when we finished training or a match at night, that if they could play together, if they could, there were three different clubs, they'd beat any team at the present days. They were very good.
From the 50s, Jim, then I suppose 58, I suppose then would be what happened that time. Like he played in the South in 58 in the South Division.
We met Benog in the South. I knew we were getting, our time was up, but we were doing our best. Benoit had a great team that year now in 58, a very good team. But whatever was in it, whatever.
The Dunbarts and them, I suppose, Jim.
Ah, sure, you had two or three Dunbarts. Mick Mom was a great, Mick Mom, Lardon, the Sheehan. So you had three Sheehan, John Sheehan, Denis Sheehan, and Jim Sheehan. And
Father Storm, I suppose.
Yeah, Father Liam. He was. Yeah. Oh, Willie Lynch. Yeah. Willie Lynch. Very good. That was a good. You're lot of Dunn. You're straight for Jolly Dunn, but and Dim.
Great players.
But and then they were. The most of them were that bit younger than us, you know. The good bit younger. A lot of them were very lot younger than us. And all our team were gone. We were gone older that same. So, I was captain of that whole team. God, we were nearly a bit surprised to win it, you know. But we won, didn't we? We sat on 59, we ran again in 59. I have some feeling that it must be around 1960 or that drive I packed it up anyway.
Well, the curtain came down our career in 1960, Jim.
Yeah, I think so, around 1960. We had... they were a great. It was nice. It was nice to be involved with that team in all Yorkshire. They were great characters. They were a fine team.
Of course, you didn't finish with the club team after that, as I said earlier at the start of the programme. You were involved up to a couple of years, of course, Jim.
I was, unfortunately, but not success.
Yeah. What happened there, Jim? Because mentioning that the South final against Linlow, we have heard, of course, that we had better teams and they didn't win. Would you agree with that, Jim?
Oh, God, of course they would. Yeah. Oh, there's no doubt about that, yeah.
But, was the approach to what all along, Jim, and, from 58 to what was wrong, you don't put up in point of
Hardly. Might be. Do you know, we had great teams. I thought that we were going to win the county, mind a few years thereafter we going off. There mightn't be great straight after we going up now in the early, but showing on to the 70s, yourself was involved now, Mickey.
Yeah.
I didn't awful feeling that he's a great team that time.
Yeah.
Willie White was good. I thought he was promising to be a great holder at that time. Neddy Murphy, Ned Doerr, Jimmy Cullinan. Ned Cullinan.
Ned Cullinan, exactly. Yes. That was Luke again, I suppose, Jim.
If we got our way, if the selectors got their way at that time, we'd have won.
I see.
There isn't a doubt in the world. But we had a few awkward people, and we had a few awkward people that made things that made life awkward for us. And it ruined the parish. It definitely did. And I knew very well that Father Ryan was a great man. There's no doubt about it. Oh, his heart and soul was involved in it.
Well, another priest in the parish, Jim. Father White, PP, he was a great friend of ours, Jim, and he admired the on and off of the field, I think. And how did that come about?
I don't know. He was an awful nice. Father White was an awful fine priest, not an awful nice man. He loved the crack. He loved the joke, and suppose the boys were good to tell him. There mightn't be all the truth, but he was enjoying it. Of course, he was a neighbour, number one. He was a Brodyman, and I used to work for his brother, cut and save the hair for his brother, Willie White, over in Brody, and wine it, all wines at him, and put it in for the hair for. But when we'd be over serving the hair, Father White would always knock around this big mid over, the glaive, they used to call it, the glaive. So and he'd be with us, and Willie White would bring out the tea, and we'd light out the butter with wine, and when we'd have 10 or 12 fillers together, the crack.
All the jokes,
everything. And that wasn't take a bit of notice of Father White, and the fact that he'd been a priest, everything.
You used to enjoy him.
Willie's staff. He's come over specially for us. Especially for us. But then he'd go back in, Tiley Murphy in, and he'd sit down and say,
that's Henry Doerr.
Henry Doerr. Ily, of course, you might as well put it in television, didn't you? Everyone that had come in, Father White was good to anything that we'd live out to see, he'd put a little bit onto us and he'd make it better.
Jim, I mentioned Father White there, when we were growing up, Jim, in our room, we hadn't the privilege of seeing that three in a row playing. Well, we see on that 58 team, all right, as I say, but. You were captain, of the three in a row team. Was it the way the team had great respect for you, Jim, or were you born leader or what? So you were,
probably the last, a good leader. I think. I always drive the team. I always let on to get vexed and everything. I always drive the boys. I always often get vexed with me until the match was over. I really find out that it was only all a joke. I used to upset the opposition as well. And then I'd draw the field. I remember one year, it was in 54. Yeah, in 55 now, for Sean Murphy was... the fact of I'd been there in 52 and 53, I'd beat automatic chase in 54 again to be captain of the team again. But Father McCarthy, he came down to Castletown this night anyway, and he presided at our general meeting. And I said to myself, I said to Sean Murphy, I said, I won't go for the captain of the team this year. Just you go. Well, I thought that it might make it easier for myself. And then again, Sean was after winning in All-Ireland. It might be wrong anybody, but in 54 he won the All-Ireland anyway. It was in 55, this happened. I said to Sean, go. You're after winning All-Ireland, so you're entitled to be captain of the team. But Sean went. We did not. No blame to Sean for that. Sean was really so much interested in the Hurling, he wouldn't say one word to the boys. But I was different. I was continuously abusing him. Another thing, I used to make switches in the team. I used to be changing them this way and that way, and there was no such thing as a manager, someone on the side, and certainly can't know someone was there that time, but all that was done, I used to do that from the field, from inside.
Well, even to mention yourself, even the Morrissey family, even Jim, he commanded great respect in the parish. Would you, maybe your help on and off of the field, maybe from over at me and Jim, and how would you feel about that? Even from to all over the county, so to go from one end of the county to the other, you draw down about Hurling or something. Well, the Morrisseys seem to always crop up.
We'd a way about it. We always meet the people and everything.
But you were willing to help, Jim.
Willing to help, I know that. And even if we'd be tough and do our part inside in the field, we never did anything wrong to anybody. We were respected for that, I think, anyway. Not saying that any of the Castletown players, the rest of the Castletown players did, but I'll always think of the first time that Feehan beat us coming back again. That was in, we were after beating South Liberty's row. South Liberty was after beating us and came out. That was an awful unfortunate day. We scored 6 goals and 6 points and we were beating 7-7 in the county. So that was the other Pro D won the county. Yeah. But Liberty's invited us down that year, down to the four elms. A night we had there now. But it was the Morrisseys that were invited down there. The Morrisseys and Joe Cock and a few. We had an awful celebration, like Paddy O'Day and Mick Croker and that thing. But,
So, I suppose Jim, we're coming nearly to a close. As I say, your Hurling career spanned a great number of years.
I met the best men of all time. That was one thing that I could say, like when the show is over. It is nice to go through the men until I met them all. Yeah. Take that year now, that the first at 20 years of age, I met the likes of Timmy Ryan in 45. Yeah. Later with Chrome, I spent an hour on Jackie Powell. Yeah. Then in the league, I was with Limerick for 2 years, nearly continuously in the league. And playing with the likes of Mick Mackey and John Mackey and Timmy Ryan and all them. You know, when he came back to me and Jonah Hurling after, Jonah Hurling and Mackey, it comes very easy to you. When you start at your youthful age, meeting the really top notches like them, you know. I was unlucky, I think, today. I never got any, you know, we never, there was one great team, and I always think of a team. It is gone. The Tormund Fish.
Yeah.
I was playing with Limerick that year in the Tormund Fish. That was around 1945. I think one of the two players are better in the find the Tormund Fish. I'd love to get that team. It was all the greats of Limerick were playing with that. I was the only youngster, the only outsider.
Well, we
that I think, we might get it sometime.
Mm. Well, I suppose. As you can see, this is a man we could be talking to for another couple of hours, Jim. And maybe, who knows, we might have another chat with him again. But as I say, as darkness has fallen here in the home of Jim Morrissey and time running out, I suppose there is much more for us to say this evening, only that we might be back again next week with another programme of Talk of Times Past. And until then, slán.